Food, I think, is one of the basic needs for us to live. We need food. Food is something which always attracts people. Food is something which always attracts you to make some connections. Let's give that an example. Indian restaurants, when it was being introduced in the UK, and then people get to know the Indian foods, their culture. So food is the gateway, I think, to know somebody's culture.
Bem-vindo, minha vizinha. Welcome.
Hello, Ranji family. Welcome.
Shagotom and welcome everyone to MD's Kitchen.
يا أهلا وسهلا بالضيوف. والله شرفتونا. يا حي الله.
Welcome to our house. Here you go.
Oh yes, I just like to share with everybody about that special plant for me. Its name is couve galega, and I brought the seeds from Portugal 5 years ago, and the plant is very well in England. I feel very happy here. Feel very, very happy in England. Me too.
I choose the napolitana because it's my favorite dish of dessert. I quite love it when I was in Syria, and I just was like wondering how I will cook it, how I will learn to cook it. Yeah, actually the first time it wasn't good when I made the napolitana, especially my brother. He's always comment in my
the first
food.
Time was it? So the taste absolutely horrible. I don't like it at all, honestly.
No, it's not horrible. It was more than horrible.
I think so, yeah. But after that, a while, he's improved slowly, slowly, improved. But today, I was honestly impressed. Honestly, guys.
You sure?
The taste, honestly, remind me the dessert I used to eat it in my village.
Really? I'm absolutely proud of that, so. Bro.
Well, brother, I have to encourage you. You know?
Oh, thank you for
because
that.
Because you know, I can't cook, I can't do anything.
Oh, I appreciate
can't just
that.
Just clean. Yeah,
yeah, you know. No, I'm the top chef. You know what I mean?
Top chef? You are too far.
Oh, really?
Chef, honestly.
When I was truck driving in Iran, I started for cooking. I had a stove, little stove in the lorry, and sometimes I cooked some my friends, some lorry's drivers. Maybe 10 or maybe 12, because they prepare some rice and meats and carrots from lots of lorry drivers, because they knew about my cooking.
Being an asylum seeker myself, I thought that this is something I can offer to the community. And this transferable skills, I thought I should use it in a Little Help Dinner Club, which I named MD's Little Help Dinner Club. In each time, I invite a community person and an asylum seeker in that dinner club, and I cook some nice dishes for them. So when they come, they talk to each other. Maybe that person I invited never knew any of the asylum seekers before. I thought, because they're in the community, there's a lot of misconception about asylum seekers is going. So arranging this kind of little gathering may create some bridges in the community between these two groups, asylum seekers and the community members. One of the asylum seekers, I would say, he was a victim of slavery and trafficking. He told me that during my stay in 4 years, nobody has asked me that, do you like to come and have food with me? And it was so emotional moment when he was leaving. He was literally nearly crying and saying that nobody has asked me that I should have come and food with someone I don't know in the community, and somebody will cook for me. And he was saying that my mom used to do that for me, but in my relatives maybe in back home, but nobody here. And this is my mom's last word, actually, that be there for your community, be there for people. Something good will happen in return, and I'm doing that. Caldo verde is the soup I make today. And I would like to share this kind of soup as well, because it's a traditional soup in Portugal. But is also is very, very healthy, because that I would like to share with the world. too many countries in the world now, they don't have a possibility to put seeds in the soil because they don't have any water, and they have lots of problems to produce food for them. If possible, I would like to make a huge production of Couve Galega and spread around the world, help countries who this moment, unfortunately, they cannot grow green leaves. And because Couve Galega is one of the most powerful leaves in the world, I think about that, and this is my dream.
I used to live in a camp. This is like the biggest camp in the Middle East for Syrian.
Our daddy told us, go with your sisters and your mother and your brothers. Just tell them it's just like 2 or 3 weeks, and then we'll get like safe, yeah. And we will like, go back. Soon to our country, and then takes years. It's really awful. When we left Syria.
We were thinking that like
2013, I guess. 2013.
2012,
I think. Okay, he's always like at plus.
Yeah.
Actually, this stew and this food is historical from maybe many years ago in Iran. My mother is very good cooking, but the tasty for this food, absolutely perfect from my wife. We have lots of cooking from Iran, maybe 2 or 3 of them is delicious, more delicious from my mother, but some of them more delicious from my wife. But I tried to cooking with love when I accept the cooking, when I agree for the cooking. I think food needs 2 things. I think it needs long time to prepare that, and love during the prepare that is really important.
You take the pan and you
flip it in the big dish like that.
Flip it in the big dish.
Yeah.
And then directly.
For me, cooking is a serious stuff because I'm presenting myself and my whole culture to someone else. So it has to be very, unique. And top of that, healthy. This is what I always try to make sure. In my country, obviously, culture to culture varies. You probably had the sandwich here before, which is we didn't have it back home. So pakora is sort of like sandwich type of things in back home. I like cook because I know what I put in the pan. I know what I eat. I know what I give to my family, my friends, healthy and good food. And this is big responsibility, but I like to do it.
We don't know the value of the mom when she's like, stand by you, or like always see her in the house.
Yeah, she used to make to us like a bread.
We called it in Arabic like khubz saj.
Yeah, it's really big. Saj.
We called it khubz saj. It's really big, the size. So big.
Yeah, like each one bread, like it's like a duvet.
Yeah, it's like a duvet. You can't like cover it yourself.
Yeah, but it's really bread.
I have 2 families. A family's community around me, and this is a world, in the world, not only in the city or in the country, in the world. And I wish I could sooner in the UK, maybe 20 years sooner or maybe 10 years sooner. But it's not a problem. I can arrange it from now. But for my family, if you mean my wife and my daughter, we have very good connection, me and Saina. I can't explain a lovely connection together sometimes, and I think this is enough for a father and for a daughter.
I think for me, the most and the beautiful things in the world is when we share our knowledge with people and we laugh together and eat together. This is very, very good. I love it.
We helping each other. We support each other.
Yeah, we really.
We learn from each other. We helping each other.
We know because I usually get up, it's like very early, you know, and do my prayer because I am Muslim, and sometimes I fast like twice a week, and then I go in the morning and try to wake up my brother, and then he didn't listen sometimes. He's like a dead, honestly, he's dead.
So he's my alarm as well. Like if I don't wake up in the morning, he wake me up.
Because of modernization, social media, actually I have seen the trend that our food habit is changing slowly. And this diversified community all over the world we have in the UK, I think food is the only first gateway maybe to give you some, you know, easy access to other communities and get to know each other.